want to make buttery smooth transitions to make your videos look sick in DaVinci Resolve, but you don't know how to. In this video, I'm gonna go over three things that you can do in DaVinci Resolve to make your transitions buttery smooth. So, let's get into it. First, if you're new here, hit the subscribe button and the bell notification to be updated on the newest videos put out. So the first thing you can do to make your transition smooth is to mess with the curves in the Spline tab. Now I'm gonna show you what I mean, but I'm gonna quick make like just a little whip transition right here so you can see how I exactly do it. And you guys get to learn how to make a whip transition, so that's cool. So you have your clips, and what you're gonna do is you're gonna go to the end of the first one, and you're going to move back 6 frames. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And you're gonna make a cut. And then you're gonna grab this one, your second clip, and you're gonna actually move it on top just like this and make another cut. And now instead of moving it back, what I'm gonna do is I'm actually just gonna flip these around so this one is still on top. And then I'm gonna highlight both of these, right click, do new fusion clip, and then I'm just gonna put my playhead over it and click on fusion. So now you see we have our two medias. We have our media in one and our media in two. So I'm gonna put one in the first viewer and two in the second viewer, and then I'm just gonna quick rename them by hitting F2. But now that we've renamed it, all that stuff, we need to just add our transform. So on each of these, we need to add a transform. So click on the first one, and then the transform is right here on the hotbar. Same thing, transform. Also, if you don't have this hotbar right here, you're just gonna go to the fusion section up here, and you're gonna just check show toolbar, and this should pop up. So we're gonna go to our merge, and we're going to click on the first viewer, put it in the first view. You can just hit this button right here, or hit 1 to put it in the first view. For the second view, which is this right view, you're gonna either hit this button, put it in there. This is for the transform node. So here's where the magic happens. We're gonna keyframe it, make sure it's on 0, and then we're going to add a keyframe on 0 and go all the way to the end. And under center, the X position, we're just gonna add a 1 instead of a 0. So that's gonna move out of the way. So now we see that the clip is moving to the side, and we do the same thing for the other one, but instead we're trying to move this clip into the frame. So it has to start out of the frame. So we're gonna add a negative right here on the center. This is for transform 2, right? This is what we're transitioning to. So it's gonna start off of the frame, then you're gonna add your keyframe. We're gonna go to the end, which is the 5th frame, and we're just gonna remove the negative, and it's just gonna pop in there. So now we have this really trippy freaking effect. Don't use this. This is where the magic happens. So we're gonna open up the Spline tab, and we're gonna expand it. At first glance, it's a little intimidating, but toggle everything on. And then we're gonna fit to zoom right here. So since they're all moving in the same direction, they should be one line. We're gonna highlight them and we're gonna hit F. You see that we have these bars right here? What we're gonna do is I'm gonna bring them all the way in. I wanna make a curve, like a really abrupt, fast curve. I just wanna toggle this off so I can't mess with this line. So there, you can still see the line, I can't move it. We grab the top now and we just make this L. It's gonna be very sharp, it's gonna be very abrupt, but it's gonna look super smooth, super fast. So that's good. And then we're going to do the same thing for the other one, but we're gonna try to match it exactly. So fit to zoom again. So once you've recreated these curves right here, we're just gonna pull this down again, just quick run back to here, and we'll just see like what it looks like. So it's fast, but that's not it. It can even look better. So the second thing you can do to make your transition smoother is to add motion blur. So we're gonna click on our merge node, and we're gonna do control space, and we're gonna type in directional blur. Let's grab this first one and add it. So now we want it to blur all of this together. So let's go to frame 2, and we're going to click on length, then we'll go all the way to the end right here, and we will just jack it up like that. The blur just brings it all together and sells that whip pan transition kind of thing. So let's just quick look at it all together. And just like that, it's quick and it's smooth and it looks really nice. You're like, whoa, it just whips out of the way. And to sell the transition even better, have a transition on a beat. And the third thing that you can do to make your transitions buttery smooth and seamless and all that good stuff is actually less to do with DaVinci Resolve and more to do with how you shoot your footage. I assume that most of you are familiar with the idea of shooting your transitions in camera. So how like this kind of works is that you actually know the shots that you're gonna get and you know how they're gonna work together. You're ultimately shooting the video and the transitions in the same thing, as opposed to going into DaVinci Resolve and making a crazy awesome transition. All your work should be in DaVinci Resolve is maybe adding some motion blur, but most likely it's just a cut. If you need like an explanation of this, look it up. I know Jesse Driftwood made an awesome masterclass all about these in-camera transitions. All right, so there you have it. Three things that you can do to make your transitions buttery smooth. Before you click off the video, we're nearing 1,000 subscribers on this channel. If you guys have any cool ideas of like a way that we could celebrate, let me know in the comments below. I think it'd be super cool. I feel like we have to celebrate in some kind of way, or there has to be like some kind of crazy video, because like 1,000 subscribers is like mind blowing to me. I don't know. I started this thing like 3.5, maybe 4 months ago, and I got 1,000, almost 1,000 subscribers now. It's wild. Let me know in the comments below if you guys have any cool, crazy suggestions. Like, I'd totally be down for something. So anyway, the video on the top is all about the parallax effect in DaVinci Resolve. It's a crazy, mind-bending effect. Check it out. And the video on the bottom is a video that YouTube thinks that you would like. But until the next one, peace.